Parshat Chukat. Throughout the Middle Ages, and even into the early 20th century in Europe, there used to be disputations between representatives of the Catholic Church and well-known Jewish representatives. The point of these disputations was always to embarrass the Jew. Rav Meir Shapiro, the very famed and unique Rosh Yeshiva of Yeshivat Chachmei Lublin in Poland. Rav Meir Shapiro, who founded the notion of Daf Yomi, which has catapulted to such amazing success in terms of Torah study. Rav Meir Shapiro participated in one of these disputes, public disputes, in the early part of the 20th century. The Catholic representative charged him with belonging to a very difficult and inhumane religion. He cited a statement from the Talmud. Atem Nikraim Adam, you, the Jewish people, are called Adam, humans. Vehem, and they, the rest of the world, are not considered Adam, humans. And he asked, in a very demanding fashion, how can you Jews complain of anti-Semitism when you seem to call everyone else subhuman, nether humans? Only you are humans. Rav Meir Shapiro answered, and his answer is very important, especially today. Our Bible, Parshat Chukat, chapter 19 of the book of Numbers, verse 14. Zot Torah Adam, this is the law of a human being. When a human being dies in a tent, anyone who comes into the tent, or anyone who happened to be in the tent, becomes ritually impure for 7 days. What does this law mean? And I want to give you one important preface. There are four different terms for a male human being. Adam, Gever, Enosh, and Ish. Three of these four have a plural term. Gever, Gvarim, men. Enosh, Anashim, male people. Ish, Ishim, male personalities. Rav Meir Shapiro explained as follows. The law tells us that if a human being dies, although all ritual impurity takes place only with physical contact, but when a human being dies, if you just happen to be under the same tent of that human being, no matter how lengthy that tent may be, it can be miles in length, and the corpse may be in one end and you're in the other end, you become ritually defiled. Explained Rav Meir Shapiro as follows. Jews have a very special, unique character. When one Jew is hurt, is murdered, especially attacked by anti-Jewish people or feelings, every Jew throughout the world feels it and identifies with it. When the Jews were in trouble in the former Soviet Union, there were demonstrations all over the world. After the Kislev plague, pogrom, which took tens of Jewish lives, there were demonstrations all over the world. this kind of reaction is really not true among the Gentiles. The Copts in Egypt, Christians, were under the gun. There was no outcry of Christians all over the world. When Muslims are killed in one place, there's no outcry of Muslims all over the world. In the case of the Jews, it's true. Because, explained Rav Meir Shapiro, there are plural words for every noun referring to the male. Gever gvarim, enosh anashim, ish ishim. Adam is a single noun referring to all Jewish people as one organism. Atem Nikraim Adam. The Jews are called Adam, one single people. If a Jew hurts in one end of the world, he'll demonstrate in the other end of the world. That's really not true with the other nations. And I had a taste of that this week. I was in New York and I was in Los Angeles, East Coast, West Coast. Wherever I went, I couldn't walk two steps without someone asking me about the three boys, about Naphtali, Gilad, Eyal, who were taken captive by evil monster human beings who are nether human beings, who are terrorist human beings. Everyone hurt, all over the world, wherever there were Jews. That's what it means. The Jews are Adam, a single organism. Feel for each other as long as we are all under the tent of the Jewish peoplehood to a tremendous degree. May the Almighty God bring back quickly, in good health, in body and in soul, Yaakov Naftali ben Rachel Frankel, Gilad Michael ben Bat Galim Shire, Eyal ben Iris Teshura Yifrach. Jews are praying all over the world that they should be brought home safely. Kein Yehi Ratzon.